What's good? Walking out by the river, gonna get some dinner. River, some dinner. They're laughing at me because I really like my selfie stick. What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy Aiden here. I hope you can hear me. I'm out in the middle of a run near this beautiful ass river right near my gym. I love running on this river, it's fantastic. But I just got off the phone with a quick little interview with Men's Health. They will be featuring a couple of different guys who are running in the Ultimate Men's Health contest, but today was my feature, which was really awesome. I love all the support I've gotten from them. It's really nice to know that they really don't care if I'm trans. They really don't. And they don't care if anybody else running is trans. It doesn't seem to be the focus. Their focus is, what does a guy mean? And because that's such an open-ended gray area question, it could be anything. So it's really amazing. Shout out to them and all the support they've given to the trans community as a whole. So I wanted to, my selfie stick, I'm sorry, but I get made fun of this for this thing, but it's freaking awesome. Look at this thing, it's awesome. So if you don't already know, FTM Magazine featured on their spring edition, the cover of their spring edition, which I'm super excited for. It's a trans culture magazine. I'll put the link below. It was started by a guy in the community, still run mainly by him and some other volunteers and such. So it's a small company, but they're doing amazing things. You should definitely check them out. I want to talk about the interview because the interview was really, really vulnerable for me. We were in studio, in my shop, making shirts, doing orders, and it's all about my company, 0.5cc, by the way. So yeah, it was really vulnerable to put myself out there and like show everybody what I do day to day and answer questions that are really personal to me. But and honestly, when I first read it, I was really nervous. I was nervous about putting myself out there. I was nervous about any negativity or, you know, just, I don't know. I don't know what I was nervous about. I was nervous about wearing my soul and my heart on my sleeve, I guess. I figure if you let people in, then they can attack you, right? But if you let people in, you can put away all your valuables before they come in. You can put away your fragile stuff, you can put away your china, you know what I mean? You can do these things. So I didn't want to do that though. I didn't want to. I wanted people to come in, and you know what? If you smash something, I don't need it because I'm still whole. I have myself. So yes, was I vulnerable? Was I scared as hell? Yes, I was. But now that all this attention and this, you know, all this media and stuff, I'm really happy that I did it because it really puts a perspective that I think just seeing pictures of me online and stuff, you won't get. When it comes to this article, it's very raw, and I'm happy that it's out there now. And I know not everyone's gonna read it, and even people who read it might not think it's all that raw, but for me it is, and that's what's important. Putting that authenticity out there for me. I mean, that's like my feeling of the years. I want to just feel authentic through all of this. I really do. It's important to me to do that. It's getting cold over there, so I gotta step in the sun. Check out the magazine. Things have been going crazy. I'm going back to New York for a wedding, so I'm gonna bring you guys with me. I just did a hike. I got a new haircut, by the way. You can't really tell. I usually do my own hair, but I got my a new haircut. Like I said, you can't really tell. And it's not done. I mean, I just went for a hike and stuff. But I figured if I'm going to be doing all this freaking, like, you know, anything, I should just get a haircut. I think maybe I should, like, you know, get one so I don't look like a homemade mess. And then also, I had a friend of mine, Wendy Kai. She's a tattoo artist. You could check her out on my Instagram. She, you know, she also saw everything and she was like, we gotta fix up your Simba. You can't be taking photos with that Simba. So, although it's a little raw right now and I might get yelled at for being in the sun with it, this is my tat right now. As you can tell, he got a little bit, it's still scabby, but we put this around him. He was looking faded and a little, you know, he looked like he needed some extra love, so we were giving that to him. Otherwise, guys, I'm just super excited. Thanks again for all the support. Keep voting. Please keep voting. And I've got more awesome things coming for you, and I'm going to take you with me on every cool thing we do. All right? This is you and me here. All right? It's us as a community. It's not just me as a whole. I watched the Harvey Milk, and I love that he said, someone said to him, you're running? And he said, I'm running, but I'm not running, the community is running. I'm just a pawn in that, you know, in that chess game. You know, the community is the hand moving the chess piece. I just happen to be the chess piece in this moment. And I really connect with that. I feel like that's me, like, for right now. And there's all the, like, you know, the chess piece. There's like, I don't know how many chess pieces, like 18, 21, I don't know. So there's all these chess pieces and we all play a role, you know? I'm just trying to play mine to the best of my ability so that we as a community can win the game, you know? That's all I'm trying to do here. And I know a lot of you guys see that. You know, you can't be in a bad mood when you have the sun shining and this river behind you, you know what I mean? All right, guys, that's going to be it, and I'll talk to you later. Peace. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Also, check me out on all my other platforms, and don't forget to vote!